A little pond in Alley Pond Park near Grand Central Parkway gets my attention on August 25, 2019. My son found some frogs here. I take samples from that pond. The sample of water comes with seed shrimp, cyclops and daphnia that I recognized right away. I also pick some plants with dirt. Different tiny creatures like to rest on plants, so picking plants is a sure way to get those creatures. Most tiny creatures are attracted to light. That is where algae grows, so I keep nurseries with creatures on a windowsill exposed to direct sunlight. Covered to reduce evaporation. Here is a close-up view of a daphnia. It is scared by a seed shrimp. Okay, here's another one. I move the sample into a larger nursery. Add dechlorinated water. The plant in this sample comes with filamentous algae. It is very difficult to remove filamentous algae from an aquarium. I add a pinch of homemade fish food flakes to boost algae growth. I notice something that looks like a nymph or larvae of some insect. Nymphs eat other nymphs and whatever small creatures they can catch. Here's a close-up view of the nymph. There are a lot of creatures for the nymph to eat. I add a mulberry leaf on September 1st. September 3rd. Allophorus vaga, aquatic case-carrying worms, show themselves in the past week. September 14th, 2019. The filamentous algae is already taking over the entire nursery. It's great for creatures, but, well, I don't need filamentous algae in my aquariums. I use a pipette to move some creatures into another nursery, avoiding filamentous algae. I should have it done in the first day when I got this sample. It would be simpler then. The rest of the sample has to be discarded. September 26, 2019. It's been about a month since I took the sample. There are no signs of filamentous algae. Now I can build a larger nursery to culture daphnia and seed shrimp. In the meantime, I add some common green algae to feed all those creatures. Here you can see a case-carrying worm. There are a lot of seed shrimp. Seed shrimp feed on any organic materials, the ultimate survival. Let's see if I can show you daphnia. Right here. Daphnia feeds mostly on common green algae. Here is a nursery 2 days later, on September 28th, with crystal clear water. Have fun and happy aquariums!